Howdy folks, my name is BJ Fishpie, and this is the story of the Sunkings.
We'd go across each other because we both played on the streets.
Back in them days, you had Johnny Skidmark, old man Jimmy McShandy, Hinging Bracket, and Cammy and Camel Toe.
I went to the Duende, where him and Stu were doing open mic and playing. He had his guitar nicked because he was pissed on the metro one night. I saw the guitar and God knows what else. And I said, well, I've just bought a new one, I can lend you my old Emporia. And if you beat me in, I think it's Porta Ferreza. And he's like, there's a guitar, jump in and play if you want. He's like, yeah. We hope we done the first song that I played together was 20 Flying Rock or something like that. I've got these, like I said before, six or seven shows. And then in the meantime, I started playing Big Flash as a sub group. They thought, okay, let's do them together. And so the rest of the shows were the Sunkings. At one point, we managed to float the PA, and another time, there's Flash and Philip trying to get the PA to work, and I'm like, you haven't turned it on. I'm like, The Limerick was a good play. The Limerick was where it all sort of started. Then we got the coolers. Coolers where I started drinking again.
For payment, rather than give the monkeys peanuts, the cheapskates gave us cheap scotch instead.
That was where the Sunkings started being filthy bastards. That's a bit rude. And Flash is like, well, fucking listen to this.
It was T-Bone Fisher, my auntie's cousin's next door neighbor's wife's long lost cousin. He got his buddy, but John, those critters, a regular slot at the Quiet Man.
The Quiet Man. Hey, alcoholics. We'd must have been 8 months there, two, sometimes 3 nights a week. We had a lot of fun. It's a shame that none of the shows are recorded.
Then it was Martin. I just kept that liquor flowing. And as time surely went on, those boys collected a bunch of loyal fans.
With a guy called Fish, who is an old reprobate blues man.
One particular Saturday night, the Sunkings saved T-Bone Fisher's sorry little ass.
Yeah, these guys came back with the dawn the next night. I mean, the guy looked like Brick Top Tommy from Snatch. Approached me, came right up to me, showed me the back of his hand. He said, that's what that fucking cunt's gonna fucking get if you don't go off that fucking stage.
Oh,
of course, it was Marcus. He used to bring all his buddies down. Okay, McFilthy, tell us about
Marcus. Was a guy who followed us around probably for the first year, 18 months. We'd ever hit the concert was Flash, Flash, Cadillac, Cadillac. Followed by either him or you going, fuck off, Marcus. And then he just disappeared one day. So that was Marcus, the faggot.
One time we changed our name from the Sunkings to Vicious Elvis. Flash decided one time to do the Nasty Beatles, which is like basically get up on stage and play a load of Beatles stuff. None of it rehearse in totally different keys to what we know it in. Because I know it in one key, he knows it in another key, and it was like a disaster. And just after that we stopped playing at the Quiet Man. We got a Sunday night show at the Kabul, which is a youth hostel. Full of young, stupid Americans. They didn't stand a fucking chance.
The bar staff were ripping us off, so we told them to shove it.
I got a room, we used to rehearse there two or three times a week. Flash had turned up with a slab of beer and we just drink a lot while we were playing. Everybody in the flat loved what we were doing, especially a certain guy who loved us playing Wicked Game, as you can probably see on the video.
Right.
last sort of shows were another gallery opened for a friend of mine.
I got something to say. Okay. What am I talking about? I believe in freedom of speech. Honey, I'm a little high, but I love the camera. Should I?
No, you look great. I got it.